Now, he's a BAFTA award-winning television star and the director of two acclaimed films, but Richard Ayoade is famously shy. So shy, in fact, that when he wrote his latest book, he interviewed himself.
What is it?
This, Jen, is the internet.
Who is Richard Ayoade? That's the question the world, or some people in it, have been asking ever since The IT Crowd, the award-winning comedy about computer support. Ayoade has also played significant roles in surreal comedies, like Garth Marenghi's Dark Place and The Mighty Boosh. But he isn't just a comedian and actor. Richard Ayoade is also a director of two acclaimed films, the coming-of-age drama Submarine and The Double. Famously inscrutable, Ayoade is no fan of interviews, so now he's written a book, Ayoade on Ayoade, in which he interviews himself about himself and the film industry. Once in a generation, a man writes a book. This is that book, I Am a Man, he says. So will the real Richard Ayoade please stand up, or sit down, if you prefer. Richard Ayoade is here. So if you were asking yourself a question now, what would it be?
I mean, couldn't you get anyone else to come? Perhaps that would be the question. I mean, in a way, the book's a comic book about film, really. It's not a deconstruction of the idea of interviews, particularly. Hopefully it's a container for jokes that is themed around film.
So it's not about Richard Ayoade at all?
No, any more than the Moose story by Woody Allen is about his grappling with wildlife.
So, what would you then ask yourself?
You know, the 2,000-year-old man that Mel Brooks played wasn't actually 2,000 years old.
Really?
He was still Mel Brooks.
Oh, okay.
It's not possible to be 2,000-year-old. He was kind of joking.
But it's like, you see, I mean, you know what happens now, in that normally, in an interview like this, I ask you a few questions about your book.
Yes.
Because that's what you're trying to sell.
Yeah.
I'm not allowed to promote your book because of broadcasting rules.
Of course.
So I then ask you something serious.
Yes.
Now, the serious thing I'd like to ask...
Which I will parry.
Is that you're the son of a Nigerian and a Norwegian.
Yes,
another
one.
Which is quite unusual. And I wonder, do you feel a very strong sense of being a role model for British Norwegians?
I do, and I feel that Norway as a nation looks to me and my activities in many ways to marshal any kind of policies that they can drum up and have been doing so for a while. In fact, they're starting to send me the Christmas tree rather than directly to Trafalgar, but they just send it to me now.
But do you think there should be more British Norwegians on British television?
I think there should be more Norwegians everywhere. I feel, you know, they have a relatively high birth rate and the population stays the same. They're fleeing. It's like rats leaving a ship and they just can't, you know, they're everywhere. It's, you know, it's, you can't move for Norwegians in this city, and I, for one, think it must be stopped.
Because
I don't dislike interviews. It's just it's a bit more like it's like commuting. I accept it as a part
you
of
have to
this,
do it.
But no one loves it with all But it's fine.
Well, I get that. But give me something in return. I mean, because
what
the other part of you is well, look.
That was not a good chat up line. What do you want?
That explains a lot. Oh. But. But you know,
I've given you my heart.
You are a rarity.
I'm ten a penny
in the entertainment industry right now.
I'm not in the entertainment industry.
You're not.
I don't entertain people, and no industry can be built on my nasal voice.
But you are, and you are young. Cambridge educated, black, British.
Sure.
And that's quite a rare subset.
Yes, it's a hell of a medical form.
But you're not going there, you know, while there's this massive campaign
going. Where should I be going?
Well, no, what I mean is, you know Lenny Henry and David Harewood and all those people
who are
black people in the entertainment industry.
There are others, yeah.
Have been pushing this big campaign about diversity in television.
Yes.
And you're not going to go there as a subject.
How do you mean go there as a subject?
Well, do you
go there as a subject?
I do personally.
Where are
yes.
you? Where are
I
you?
I think there should be more, but now you're interviewing me. And,
well, that's interesting.
And that's fine.
You see, what was interesting, I thought, about your interview with Tarantino, apart from the notorious nature of the kind of I'm shutting you down, was the bit when he said, "This is an advert for my movie."
Exactly.
That was the interesting bit, and that to me was the elephant in the room. Not, you know, I mean, you gainfully kind of and pushed through and tried to get him to talk about violence, which he wasn't going to do. But he was outraged that he could not advertise his film. And that, I thought, was very interesting, and is interesting about the essential lie of the interview situation.
And you're sort of doing the same thing tonight, but...
In a way, yeah.
But, Richard, thank you very much indeed for coming.
Don't thank me. I've done nothing for you.
John.